Place to Empire Field. Here's Rod Black and Dwayne Ford.
Thank you, Dave, and welcome to Vancouver on a cloudy day today here. BC Lions with their first possession, punt return. The Toronto Argonauts went two and out in their first possession. Just underway here in this rematch of week four. Casey Printer's unavailable to the BC Lions in their earlier matchup, a win by the Argonauts. Fourth quarter comeback, 24-20. So Printers sets up shop at his 25-yard line. And also significant this week, no Jamal Robertson for the BC Lions. He is hurt, and we'll see a lot of Jonas Davis.
Exactly. Jonas Davis, a guy who has just a handful of carries. He's been a special teams guy thus far. 12 carries on the season thus far for 117 yards, but he's a potential game breaker. Emmanuel Arsenault in the receiving corps has averaged over 90 yards a game over the last 4 weeks. Angus Reid back in at center with Dean Valley breaking his leg last week.
Second down, 9 yards. Printer stands in and an overthrow. So it'll be two and done for the BC Lions as well.
We'll call it a defensive struggle so far, but probably more accurately, the two quarterbacks each off the mark once in that opening, their opening possessions.
So the veteran Paul McCallum, 40-year-old Paul McCallum, will come out and join one of his most successful seasons, not only kicking the ball but punting it. Has averaged close to 42 yards, but he's known for his ability to place punts, of course. We'll let this fly from his 15 and almost had it blocked. Chad Owens fields the ball at his 46-yard line, or will he? Here he goes with some blocks. Owens down the sideline, has room. Chad Owens, Paul McCallum has to knock him out. There is a penalty flag back at the 50-yard line. We'll tell you about it when we come back to Empire Field in Vancouver.
Receiver, Dury number 32, the inside receiver on this play. He's going to end up on a deep route here. Particularly when he sees his quarterback in trouble, just uses speed to beat Stanley Franks. Franks gets hung up on the scramble. Safety Tad Crawford covers for him, but Dury goes over top to make that catch.
Look very close to being a touchdown. There is a penalty flag on the field.
The illegal substitution, 13 men in the huddle. Toronto, 10-yard penalty. First down.
13 men in the huddle, our referee today, Murray Clark, so that will move it back.
And the Argos were yelling as the penalty was being called for having 13 in the huddle. The Argos are yelling that they only had 11. They were short a man.
So the ball moved back. That looked like Andre Dury may have been able to advance that ball over the goal line. Moot point now.
Well, when you lose those yards on the penalty, it makes you think maybe you should have challenged that spot.
Play action. Once again, it's Andre Dury. Let's take a look at the Argo offense. Our starting lineup's brought to you by Rona, proud sponsor of the CFL. Rona, doing it right.
And all eyes on Corey Boyd this week, the CFL's leading rusher. Not a lot of carries last week, but had 7 catches against Hamilton. Now receiving core, Mike Bradwell in for Chad Lucas because of a shuffle due to the ratio. And on the offensive line, the man on the hot seat, left tackle Joe Appel, the second overall pick in the draft, makes his first career start. Rob Murphy out with an injury.
And in his hometown as well, second down, Corey Boyd up the middle, plows his way. He did not have to get into the end zone. First down marker was close to the 1 yard line.
Well, I like this call from Jim Barker and Jamie Elizondo. Give that ball to Corey Boyd down close. Get a quick look at this BC defense. The latest man in that defensive end rotation, Jeremy Gethers, rookie out of UNLV. Linebacking core anchored, as always, by Corey Banks, potential most outstanding defensive player. And in the secondary, Ryan Phillips. Keep an eye on him on the blitz. He had 3 sacks last time these teams met.
It will be third down. Lemon behind center. Boyd is stopped. The former Argo, Jonathan Brown, stops him. And there's a scrap in the back of the end zone. Penalty flags everywhere. Huge stop by the BC Lions and the former Argo in his first game against his old mates. JB, Jonathan Brown, puts up a wall to stop Corey Boyd. He told us yesterday the key was to stop number three. Then there was a skirmish in the back of the end zone.
Well, we'll get to that skirmish later, but a fantastic effort from Jonathan Brown coming off the edge. Great recognition from the veteran.
Only his second game, JB, Jonathan Brown, since being called back to Canada.
Yards were not gained on the play. The ball turns over to BC. After the play, major foul, face mask. BC number two, go half the distance to the goal line, first.
So the BC Lions, a long field here, but the Argos turn the ball over on downs. A guy who enjoyed a great career in Toronto, now with the BC Lions, and a big stop, one of the biggest already in this ball game early on, Jonathan Brown.
A former member of the Argo defense, now a BC Lion. Here are the guys who are still on the double blue D. Their defensive line now led by Kevin Huntley. Linebacking core anchored by Jason Pottinger, the former Lion, in the middle.
Long field now. Casey Printers from his end zone. Catch is made. Near the 15-yard line. Right away, Emmanuel Arsenault, who had a big drop in the last time these two teams met.
Well, Arsenault's been on a roll lately. This Argo defense will have their hands full stopping him. As I mentioned, Kevin Huntley now the man, with Jonathan Brown gone, Adrian O'Belly out on that D-line. Kevin Huntley anchors. Former Lion Jay Pottinger in his first full year as the starting middle linebacker. Keep an eye on the back end on Byron Parker, who had that late game-winning touchdown. There's Kevin Huntley in the middle of things. No big surprise. Big number 94 for the Argos.
See a lot of Jerome Messam as well today. They go a little thunder and lightning, the BC Lions, with Messam, who's 6'3", a big guy, big back, and Jonas Davis, who's only 5'7", and they'll share a lot of the ball in the backfield today. No Jamal Robertson for the BC Lions, out with a rib injury. Printers now escapes the pocket and goes deep downfield, coming back to the ball and almost making the catch.
Nice job in coverage by the corner, number 23, Willie Middlebrooks. Go up and fight for this football. He ends up on the outside against G-Roy Simon. Keeps his cool, playing it a little collision there, but that's all fair game as they're both fighting for the football. Good effort by Middlebrooks.
Third down now, Paul McCallum with his second punt now. This time he'll have to let this fly from about a 7 or 8 yard line. Good kick. Owens, the no yards call. Reverses field twice, Chad Owens. Can also add 15 yards on after the no yards call. So good field position now for the Toronto Argonauts. Let's go down to the sideline now and our reporter today, Farhan Lalji. Farhan.
Well, Rod, the tough guy award going into this game goes to Dante Marsh.
No
last
yards.
Week he left the game with
DC
what was believed
26.
To be a separated shoulder. Turns
penalty.
Out it was just dislocated,
first
but
down.
It's still pretty painful right now. He's wearing a harness on his left arm, so he can't get any extension past this. He was tested earlier, turned into a touchdown-saving tackle. Tackling, he says, is not going to be a problem. Here he makes the play at the 3 yard line. The big problem for Marsh is going to be getting any kind of extension when the ball is up in the air, and the coaches actually believe it might help his press technique because he'll actually have to move his feet more and he won't be able to reach.
It did not look good for Dante Marsh last week against Montreal when he left the ball game with the shoulder injury. So the Argos, after the 15-yard penalty for the BC 41, play action. Lemon goes to James Robinson. He's wide open. He has a touchdown.
And this is what we call a bust in terms of that coverage on the back end. Cleo Lemon takes advantage.
41-yard touchdown, James Robinson. His second game back with the Toronto Argonauts, and he finds the end zone.
And James Robinson ends up on the crossing route here, working all the way across the field. As he crosses that midpoint to center, he just gets lost in the coverage. You see him in behind the defensive halfback for a touchdown.
Robinson, who was with the Argos, then was released by the Argos as Cleo Lemon celebrates and then went down to the NFL. Was cut by the Cleveland Browns and found his way back to Toronto. Part of their receiving core again. And he's got his first touchdown of the season in his second game. And the Argos strike first here at Empire Field. First quarter, the Toronto Argonauts, James Robinson. It's the Argos in front. We'll see how the pattern plays out for the Argos this season. They are 5-0 when they score first. And that's indeed what they have done here so far this afternoon in Vancouver. Jamie Bourne to kick it off. Jonas Davis and also Andrew Harris are back. Harris has the ball and advances it to about the 38-yard line. So Casey Printers and the BC Lion offense back to work here.
Well, a minute ago, James Robinson and the Toronto Argonauts offense took advantage of a broken coverage by the BC Lions secondary. Robinson, the number three receiver from the top of the field, as he starts to go across the field, if you look at this in thirds, you're going to keep an eye on the defender here. He ends up following a receiver towards that left sideline. Robinson goes the other way. There's nobody covering that deep third. Nobody drops on the right side of the Lions defense. He's wide open.
We are back in Vancouver. Casey Printer's just throwing over the middle. There's a penalty flag on the play.
Pass interference.
Another incompletion.
Corner number 21. By rule, it's a 10-yard penalty. First down.
Manny Arsenal, the intended target, so pass interference to call.
Yeah, Linjay Shell, the defender, just in too early as the ball was en route.
Jim Barker's team coming into Vancouver after back-to-back losses against the Hamilton Tiger Cats. Play action again. Here comes the rush. The heat on Printers. Going downfield deep for G-Roy Simon. And Evan McCullough all over him. Simon did get a hand on it, but would have had to perform a tip drill, a juggling act, to pull that in.
And this one hung up just long enough for Evan McCullough to get into position to make this play. The defender number 24 right behind G-Roy Simon. But as Simon slows up a little bit to wait for that ball, McCullough's able to get in there and get a hand on.
Four pass knockdowns for Evan McCullough this season. Rookie out of James Madison. Second down. Again the rush. Again, Printers has to run for his life. And he heaves it downfield and was looking for O'Neill Wilson, but there was no one in the vicinity.
Well, the Toronto Argonauts are last in the Canadian Football League in terms of sacks registered. But they're getting a lot of pressure on Casey Printers here in the early going, Rod.
Casey Printers just one of six so far.
Argo's defensive line runs a twist in the middle with number 79, Eric Taylor. He comes free. Ronald Fleming's in as well. We've seen Printers with a couple desperation throws.
Two teams that are 7th and 8th, last in the CFL in passing yards. So they struggled offensively in the air. Almost blocked again. Paul McCallum was hit. No penalty flag. Chad Owens knocked it out of bounds, and there is a penalty flag at the 32-yard line.
Well, Paul McCallum did a nice job trying to sell this one, trying to sell that contacting the kicker call. As the ball's gone, his leg is still in the air. But not really much contact there, just a veteran move by Paul McCallum.
On the return, illegal block. Corner number 40, 10-yard penalty, first down.
Brian Crawford on the return, an illegal block, so the ball goes back to the Toronto 21-yard line. Much better feeling around Vancouver and BC this week for Wally Buono and the Lions, ending a 7-game losing streak a week ago against the Montreal Alouettes. Well-rested team playing a rare afternoon home game in Vancouver. Play action again. Lemon over the top for James Robinson again. Quickly becoming a favorite target now for Cleo Lemon.
The Argos offensive line doing a pretty good job protecting here so far. And the reason that's a story, a lot of changes going on. Those little arrows indicate the changes. Three changes from Labor Day, all due to injury. Joe Appellin at left tackle. Jeff Keeping at left guard. Shannon Boatman in at right tackle. Here's a look at just what these five guys are doing up front to give Cleo Lemon some time. Pretty nice protection, Joey Appel. actually taking a break of that series, Kelvin Armstrong hit at left tackle.
Lots of motion here for the Argos again, but this time they had it up the middle to Corey Boyd. Did not see a lot of the football 5 days ago against the Tiger Cats on Labor Day, prompting a lot of speculation as to why he didn't see a lot of the football, because Corey Boyd, of course, comes in as the CFL's leading rusher.
Well, and a lot of times the Argos are in situations where Cleo Lemon is reading whether he's going to hand off the ball or whether he's going to keep it. Zone read type situation. Everybody's keying on Boyd, so Lemon's got to keep the football.
First year back in the backfield again. Second down, 5 yards. Lemon will tuck it and take it himself and lunge forward. And this will depend on the spot, but it looks like it could move the sticks.
And this is a perfect example, Rod, of what we just finished talking about with that working relationship between Cleo Lemon and Corey Boyd. As Cleo Lemon fakes the ball to his running back, going to see the entire defense. Everybody's going to go to number three, Corey Boyd, on this fake. The defense converges. That means the outside is open. Cleo Lemon goes around the edge because they're not keying on him.
Here's the rush and the catch made by Spencer Watt. Has not seen a lot of playing time. Corey Banks supplying some pressure.
Well, this time the Lions do a better job defensively. Corey Banks comes off the edge and he's going to key on the quarterback this time, Cleo Lemon, when he keeps the football. Lemon doing a nice job getting the eyes downfield to find an open receiver quickly as Banks approaches.
148 yards already in the air for Cleo Lemon. Spencer Watt's second catch his young CFL career, and out of the backfield, Jeff Johnson plows forward, and they'll move the sticks again into BC territory.
The Argos mixing it up in terms of where they're distributing that football, this time going to the fullback, Jeff Johnson. Misdirection in terms of this motion comes from the receiver, Spencer Watt, coming one way. Jeff Johnson's going to release to the flat the other way. Play action once again, quick hitter. Johnson's open, gets a little rub. Some would call it a pick from James Robinson to help him out.
Lemon turns and fires the other way. A quick hitch and go to Corey Boyd. He's lined up on the line and picks up near 8 yards.
No.
This is what Corey Boyd is doing more and more as part of this Argonaut offense. His role as a receiver is growing. Jim Barker is very comfortable detaching him from the formation, i.e. lining him up as a receiver and seeing what kind of matchup they can get there to throw him the football.
Second down and two now. The 37 up the gut. Close to another first down. Argos offensively last week, again only a few days ago against Hamilton, did move the ball with proficiency early on. But when they got near the red zone, they messed up. And a few problems against the Tiger Cats. And you look back early in this ball game for Jim Barker's team, what might have been a touchdown to Andre Dury. They give the ball back on turnovers, and it was almost an old, pretty reminiscent of what you saw last time against the Tiger Cats. But then they rebounded with that touchdown toss to James Robinson.
And that's something, certainly a good sign for Jim Barker's team coming off back-to-back losses, is to be able to shake off some mistakes, not get their heads down when things start going negatively.
Grant Shaw, the rookie kicker out of the University of Saskatchewan, on his 44-yard line, a 44-yard kick now. Shaw puts it up, and this ball is wide left. Tad Crawford gives up the single point. 8-0 Argos. BC Lions elect to take the ball at 37-yard line. Branshaw missing the field goal attempt, so it's 8-0 Argos.
The other right.
Men in orange have been stymied so far. Jonas Davis makes a couple of players miss. Talked about a rare afternoon start here in Vancouver for the Lions. Good body clock time for the Toronto Argonauts. How rare is it?
Well, since October, end of October 1981 was their last Saturday afternoon kickoff here in BC.
There's the pitch. Stood up and brought down, but it looks like it will be a first down. And that's significant. A lot of teams have come in here and have always complained about moving to the west and have had struggles. Eastern teams have struggled here in BC for the night games when their body clock is accustomed to about 9:30 or 10 o'clock at night to play a football game. The Argos kind of licking their lips this week, even though it has been a short work week.
Yeah, surprising change for BC to give that up, give up that edge.
First down, and miscommunication as Printers went down in the backfield, and Davis, again, the feature back this week in place of Jamal Robertson.
Well, we talked about that advantage that the Lions have held over Eastern Division teams over the last several years, playing here at home in BC. BC Place, of course, up until this year, 24-5.
Printers in the pocket, fires, and open. Making the catch is Stephen Black, who made his debut last Friday in Montreal. An impressive one, too, when he scored a touchdown against the Alouettes. His first reception of the day. And that's the end of the first quarter, where the Argos lead 8-0, but the Lions are on the move when we come back for the second quarter in Empire Field. Double blue, he said it looked a little strange to see that orange uniform, but we'll hear more about him today as the BC Lions are marching now. First and 10 from the Argo 45-yard line. Printers back to pass. Flushed out of the pocket. Downfield, and making the catch is G-Roy Simon on his 35th birthday.
Well, happy birthday, G-Roy. Gets a gift from his quarterback, special delivery from Casey Printers. Jordan Younger, the man in coverage on G-Roy Simon on this play. He's put in a tough situation. It's difficult enough to cover G-Roy Simon in this kind of space, but when Casey Printers starts scrambling, which means you've got to cover for even longer, good luck to you.
Sixth all-time in receiving yards in the CFL. Printers firing again. Stephen Black spins, and the cousin of Cincinnati Bengal, Terrell Owens, has been impressive in his first 2 weeks in Lion Orange.
Well, Stephen Black, just one catch last week against Montreal, but he made it count with his first CFL touchdown. We've seen him with a couple of touches here. Gets open in the flat, tries a little shake and bake. The defender, Willie Pyle, not fooled, makes a tackle. Second and short for BC.
Printers in the shotgun. Jonas Davis goes in motion. Printers in trouble now. Spins out of trouble. Dancing, looking wide open. End zone. Touchdown. Jonas Davis. He couldn't yell anymore. He couldn't wave his hands anymore.
Well, sometimes when you're 5'7", you get lost among the big bodies on a football field. Such is the case with Jonas Davis. He goes in motion out wide here. Nobody stays with him. Defender loosens with him slightly, but as the scramble begins, nobody gets out to Jonas Davis. The hands are in the air. He's yelling and screaming. He couldn't be any more vocal. Couldn't be any more open. The touchdowns don't come much easier than that for Jonas Davis.
Rookie Mighty Might out of San Jose State, CFL Special Teams Player of the Month in August. That's his third touchdown as a Lion, a big one here early second quarter. Casey Printers dancing out of trouble, celebrates the first major score for the Lions of the day. Don't score many touchdowns, have, at least haven't this season, via the pass. Just their eighth this season. Jonas Davis makes good on the pass from Printers. They're on the board, down one, 8-7. Back to receive the kick is Chad Owens, trying to find some blocking help. Picks his way to the 40, still on his feet. And Chad Owens, who has become a sensation returning the ball this season, among the many sensations in the league, a 40-yard return.
Well, one of the blocks that sprung Chad Owens for that big return, the victim was Jamal Lee, usually one of the quickest Lions getting down the field. but he's become a marked man because of his special teams play. Big block by Ejiro Kwali. The Argos putting their best special teamer up against Jamal Lee.
Son of a great Canadian back, Orville Lee. First round pick of the Lions, Jamal. Oh, Cleo Lemon dropped it. Corey Banks picks it up and tripped up at the 20.
Tripped up at the 20, tripped up by the 20.
Exactly. Cleo Lemon absolutely lost the handle. And for the second straight week, Corey Banks has a fumble recovery a week ago for a touchdown. That time he also almost went the distance.
Well, Corey Banks has that knack for being around the football. He's coming off the edge from the bottom of the screen. Cleo Lemon just loses the handle. As you said, Corey Banks, when you've got a nose for the football, sometimes these ones just bounce right to you.
Another turnover by the Argos. Printers immediately out of the backfield. Once again, it's Davis to the corner. No signal. And it's at the one-yard line. And so far, Jonas Davis looking very good in his first start as the feature back in the BC Lions offense.
Well, what a throw and catch here between Printers and Jonas Davis. Davis slipping down the sidelines. Printers with a perfect little touch pass. Davis out of the backfield and up the sideline. Printers just lays it up high. He's got a mismatch with the defensive end. Ronald Fleming's the closest man trying to run with the scat back.
First and goal from the 1 yard line. Travis Lule is in, a quarterback. Hands it up the middle, and it's a touchdown. Jerome Messam.
Jerome Messam gets stood up at the line of scrimmage, but when you're carrying 245 pounds, you can take a lick and keep on rolling. Good hard run by the rookie.
Native of Brampton, Ontario, Jerome Messam.
Stood up in the hole by Jay Pottinger. But with one blocker on Pottinger, he was unable to wrap up on the tackle. Messam kept driving his way in.
BC Lions, quick strike. First it's Davis, then it's the turnover by Banks. Then it's Jerome Messam. Thunder and lightning in that Lion backfield today.
Ball over twice in the offensive green zone last week. That was the focus for the Toronto Argonauts in practice this week. Getting into the end zone when you have opportunities, not turning over the ball, but one turnover on downs, another fumble by Cleo Lemon, and it seems like that week of practice has gone right out the window.
Argos need to answer back quickly now. Especially when they had all the momentum early on in this ballgame. Corey Boyd left side and lunges forward. Looks like it'll depend on the spot, very close to a first down. And we'll likely see a lot more of Corey Boyd today. 144 carries before the game, 846 yards. CFL rushing leader, but again, over the last couple of games against the Hamilton Tiger Cats, not heard from very much.
Well, Corey Boyd, whether he's carrying the football or not, this guy is going to be a factor offensively for the Toronto Argonauts in that they run so much play action off of Corey Banks, faking the handoff, Cleo Lemon throwing the football, that the entire offense is predicated on how the defense plays against number three, Corey Boyd.
Former seventh-round pick in the National Football League, Corey Boyd. Trouble with injuries over the last couple of seasons, including training camp with the Argos where he had a concussion. Was actually released, told to stick around. Good thing he did. Good for the Argos as Boyd goes up the middle, is swallowed right there and nowhere to go.
One of the great things about Corey Boyd, and there's a lot to like about him as a football player, but here's what I love. Doesn't sulk when he's not getting the ball. Carries through on the fake and makes sure puts his lid on somebody. He gets a block. That helps bring his quarterback, Cleo Lemon. Matching up against Anton McKenzie. If McKenzie's coming to him, Boyd's not just going to sidestep him. He's going to make contact, take that defender out of the play.
Second down and 9. Empire Field very loud here. Temporary facility now for the Lions this season. And again, it's Andre Dury who's cut down and will be held well short of a first down.
Well, Davis Sanchez, the veteran corner, has seen that pass to Andre Dury in the flat so many times over the course of a week of film. Well prepared as he closed on that football as it was in the air. The veteran Sanchez, a great addition to his hometown team coming over from Montreal in the offseason.
Sun starting to peek out now. Jamie Borum, who had a kick blocked last week against the Tiger Cats late in the first half, really one of the turning points of the ball game. Lions set up the return. Once again, it's Tristan George. There's a penalty flag that flies at the 25-yard line. Beautiful day in Vancouver. And the penalty against the Lions on the return.
Well, we've seen both teams with special teams penalties early that have put them in the hole as far as field position.
Macy Printers, four career games against the Argos, has never thrown an interception. Going deep for Emmanuel Arsenault, a bump there with Willie Pyle. But incidental contact between both receiver and defender.
Well, this is a great job by Willie Pyle, the free safety, to first get his position over the top, meaning nobody gets in behind him. This is a pump and go to Emmanuel Arsenault. There's the fake by Printers. Willie Pyle recovers, gets in front. And again, that ball's in the air. They both got a right to it. Emmanuel Arsenault, we're going right down the numbers. Willie Pyle takes a perfect angle to get there and cut him off.
Six receivers set. Printers in trouble, escapes. Still on his feet, finally brought down.
Well, you don't always like to see your quarterback under pressure, but one thing I do like seeing is Casey Printers running the football from this BC Lions perspective. Printers came into this game with just 12 carries. This is a guy who can do a lot of damage with his legs. This is sort of how Casey Printers made his name in the Canadian Football League. It's a part of his game that seems to have disappeared a little bit over the course of the last couple years.
Gain of about 9 yards. Let's take a look what the sticks will tell us. So that will be third down now, and Wally Buono will not hesitate, and he brings out his kick team. And the crowd was yelling, go, 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 but the winningest coach in CFL history will bring out Paul McCallum. And the Argos, if they play this right with Chad Owens back, could have very good field position here. McCallum launching, and Owens at his 40-yard line, little stutter step. And eventually brought down out of bounds at the 46-yard line. Today, they're battered, beaten up offensive line. Rookie starter Joe Appel. Leo Lemon, here's the rush, and unable to deliver the football to Andre Dury. He's used in that scat back formation. And in the cage of Cleo Lemon, as he often is in the backfield, Corey Banks.
Well, Corey Banks and Ryan Phillips, the two guys who often come off the edges. Banks usually on the strong side or wide side of the field. Phillips coming from the short side. In this case, it's Banks who gets in to cause Cleo Lemon to hurry that throw.
Setting up another second down and 10. The Argos have been silenced here last few minutes. Lemon looks to his left for Owens. Lays out, but the catch is not made. Incomplete. And another two and out for the Argonauts. Unable to move the football right now.
Well, looked like the BC Lions had a little bit of trouble in coverage, adjusting on the left side of their defense due to the Toronto Argonauts' motion. Ryan Christian the receiver is going to come across the formation as he comes all the way across through that backfield and slips out into the flat. Ryan Phillips has to run a long way to try and get to him. They could have hit Christian for a big game there if they had seen him early.
Jamie Moore. And close to having it blocked, but draws a penalty. Roughing the kicker call coming here. Jamie Bourne was able to sell this one.
Wally Buono furious on the sidelines.
Contacting the kicker. BC number 45. 10-yard penalty. First down.
Jason Araki, the man who rushes in and makes contact with the punter, Jamie Borum, after the ball's away. Very similar to the situation we saw earlier with Paul McCallum, but the contact more solid. Araki hitting the plant foot of the punter, Jamie Borum.
Immediate first down for the Argos because of that. Preston George, who returned that football, is on the sideline and banged up. BC Lions, the most penalized team in the Canadian Football League. The Argos, the least penalized. Corey Boyd runs one and pounds it up the gut, only for a few yards.
Well, you saw the Lions punt returner, Treston George, on the sidelines dealing with an injury. This is a critical situation for the BC Lions because of who George is kind of replacing and backing up today in the punt return game and kick return game. He's taking Giannis Davis' spot because Davis has such an important role this week as the starting running back, but he also backs up Dante Marsh at corner. And as we heard from Farhan earlier, Dante Marsh is playing with a bad shoulder and is in kind of a tenuous situation as well.
Second and seven, Lemon lets it fly and on the sideline. Incomplete for Boyd. Frustrated his inability to catch the ball that time.
Well, a tough lean and catch for Corey Boyd, but he got his hands on this one. Pounding the fists into the turf in frustration as it bounced away.
Jonas Davis now comes out for the return.
The Argos unable to take advantage of that second chance given them by the contacting the kicker call against Jason Araki.
Two returners back. And they set the return up. Here's Davis. Jonas Davis fighting outside, spinning. Nice return to the 46-yard line. And there was a penalty flag on the play.
On the return, illegal block, BC number 82. 10-yard penalty, first down.
Murray Clark in with the call just in case Wally Buono's reaction didn't make it obvious that that one was going against the Lions. So the string of special teams penalties here from the BC Lions continuing to hamper them as far as field position.
Ball now back to the 29-yard line. Lions lead with 6 minutes to go before halftime. It's Jerome Messam getting the call again, picking up a couple of yards. Let's go down to Farhan once again.
Guys, the news not so bad on Treston George right now. They're telling us it's just a stinger. He doesn't have huge extension of that left arm around the shoulder area. He can't really lift it up over his shoulder, but the rotation and everything is starting to come back right now. They'll probably keep him out the rest of the half, and he'll play in the second half.
Another alum from San Jose State, the same place that Jonas Davis played. Draw play to Messam. Jerome Messam plowing forward in a big gainer.
Well, thunder shows a little bit of lightning on this one. Big Jerome Messam gets a hole on the draw. Everything drops off. BC Lions, the offensive line is going to let that pass rush come upfield, and that lane comes wide open for Jerome Messam, and away he goes. First upfield, then bounces it to the outside. The big fella shows speed.
Printers, fires, Simon, got it. And another first down. G. Roy Simon again celebrating a birthday today. Moving closer and closer to fifth place overall in the all-time receiving yardage list. Catch now in 134 straight games in what has become a future Hall of Fame career. Pump fake from Printers down the sideline. Paris Jackson has the catch. His first reception of the afternoon.
Well, Paris Jackson had been quiet in the early going after having a season high 94 yards receiving last week in Montreal. Comes up big on the broken play here.
And there's a challenge flag. You see the Lions were going immediately up to huddle and to scrimmage. No huddle, and Jim Barker throws the challenge flag, feeling that Paris Jackson did not catch that ball. Judging by the fact the Lions went right up to the line, maybe he did not. Maybe told the guys in the huddle, huddle up quick.
Well, this one's certainly going to be a close call. Because there's a place there
where he was challenging the ruling on the field of a completed pass. We'll review the play.
And it has to be conclusive. The call was a completed pass. It has to be conclusive that it was not. And so far, all these angles that will be seen at the command center back in Toronto by Jake Ireland, one of them looked like there may have been a hop in there, but tough to tell.
Well, it's possible initially that as Paris Jackson went to get his hands underneath this football, that the end of it might have gone through his elbows and touched the field. But because it's kind of concealed under his body, there are shadows in there. It's a difficult one to see. It looks like the tip of that football might have just touched down on the turf.
After review, the ruling on the field stands. Completed pass.
Completed pass. Paris Jackson moves the football inside the Toronto 30-yard line. Lions on the move here again. And has this game ever changed complexion in the second quarter? Four receivers to Printer's left. Pump fake to the end zone. And Emmanuel Arsenault unable to come up with a good coverage in the end zone.
Once again, a good defensive play by the corner, Willie Middlebrooks. He's the man who ends up in coverage on the outside against Arsenault. Middlebrooks, number 23 for the Argos. Short side corner, eyes to the quarterback, runs right with that receiver. Ball's in the air. He times it perfectly to come over with that right arm.
Emmanuel Arsenault, who had to wear the goat horns a little bit in the last loss by the Lions in Toronto when a drop pass early in the second half changed that game. Jerome Messam shows that he can carry the ball after the pass, too. Another first down, BC.
Well, Jerome Messam showing his worth, rewarding the BC Lions for their patience in this young man, a guy who they placed on their negotiation list after he was passed over in the 2008 draft. Terrific draft class. He was one of the best players in it. Teams had some concerns, but he is proving them wrong.
Davis. Pass back the other way. Look at this guy go. Down near the goal line. What a great run by Jonas Davis. Little jitterbug run close to the goal line. And when we come back, it will be first and goal for the Lions. 3-minute warning on the field at Empire Field. Jonas Davis, 24 yards on the ground. Five carries, also has a touchdown. Messam to the goal line. Touchdown!
Thunder and lightning strike again.
Jerome Messam, basically used on special teams for the most part this season, has a special day so far. Two touchdowns. Seeing a lot of the football, and the BC Lions opening up a big lead in the first half.
Jerome Messam was one of the revelations of training camp for the BC Lions. A big body with quick feet. He shows it there, getting through the hole with that speed and then dropping the shoulder to run through contact.
Wally Buono said to him during training camp, he said, you know, young man, I'm going to make you my son. I'm going to make you a football player. Jerome Messam doing some good stuff so far here today. Two touchdowns. And if it isn't Jonas Davis, it's Jerome Messam. BC Lions, a 21-8 lead when they trailed 8-0.
And a very different team offensively here.
And a half minutes before halftime, live at the half with the guys. Dave Randorf, Jock Climby, Milt Stegall, Chris Schultz. Talk a little bit about that earlier game. Hamilton Tiger Cats, Montreal Alouettes without Anthony Calvillo again, and Adrian McPherson leading his team to victory.
Jerome Messam giving thanks to the big boys up front, paving the way for him. Moments ago, we got a hug on the sidelines with Jamal Robertson.
What's up, Uncle Mike? What's up, Mark? What's up, Jason McKenzie? What's up? I'm here.
Keep it onside here, fellas.
Paul McCallum after that Messam touchdown. Ryan Christian, special teams looking to spark the Argos. Christian. At the 35-yard line. AC Printers engineers another touchdown drive.
Lions did a nice job marching after the series started with a special teams penalty that backed them up. Casey Printers, nice touch passes, spreading the ball around to a lot of different weapons. The drive finishes with Jerome Messam playing the role of the hammer rather than being the nail.
Casey Printers also supplying some blocking in that drive. Spring Jonas Davis down near the goal line. Leo Lemon in the backfield is Andre Drury with some room close to midfield. And a penalty flag flies the BC sideline.
Good hit, baby! Good hit!
The Argos respond with
major foul, face mask. BC number 2, 15 yards at the end of the play, first down.
The initial call, the face mask against Davis Sanchez on the tackle as that right hand comes up. And then Dury goes barreling into the sea of orange jerseys. That's going to leave a mark.
Quickly up, though, give them credit on that sideline. Net 36 yards after the penalty. If you don't have equipment on that sideline, you better be ready. Keep your head up. Argo's moving now and going deep again for Robinson, and he's got another touchdown. Quick strike Lemon to Robinson, and the Argos respond very quickly.
James Robinson is working a little hook-and-go type play with Cleo Lemon. Lemon puts up the pump fake. Robinson runs right by the defender on this play. James Robinson on the outside. Isolated. He's out there with Dante Marsh. Marsh gets hands on, tries to pass him off to the halfback, Ryan Phillips. A perfectly timed throw comes in from Lemon.
James Robinson, who has struggled to keep a job in the Argos lineup when he was part of the receiving corps before going to the U.S. trying out with the Cleveland Browns.
Sit down and get some water. Sit down and get some water.
Argos have always liked this guy. Robinson had some troubles hanging on to the football, recall a couple of seasons ago. Not so much today. Two touchdowns.
Well, always a guy who showed tremendous potential and physical ability. As you said, there was one point where the Argonauts even looked at him in the Don Matthews era a couple of years ago as a free safety, moving him over from the offensive side of the ball. But ultimately, a couple NFL tryouts. Cleveland spent some time with Miami Dolphins as well. He's back here in double blue and Cleo Lemon, sure glad to see him today.
Shed his old number, number 19, for number 4, a number that was worn by Kerry Joseph. Of course, no longer with the Argos. 21-15 the score. Jamie Borm will kick it off, and Jonas Davis and Andrew Harris are back. Harris gathers it in at his 10-yard line. Junior football star, a winner of the Wally Buono Award, as a matter of fact. Named for the top junior player, Canadian junior football. It's a precursor, of course, to playing with the BC Lions and playing for Wally Buono.
Andrew Harris was a complete terror in the Canadian Junior Football League, but also practiced last year with the BC Lions and worked his way into full-time employment.
Just over 2 minutes to go before halftime. It has been an eventful second quarter, to say the least. Messam stopped in his tracks this time. Alex Busby was there. Kevin Huntley also in on the play.
The Argos seem to be getting BC here in what has been a rare second and long situation in the second quarter.
Five receivers set. Printers in trouble. Brought down. And a penalty flag flies after Casey Printers was sacked. Kevin Huntley brought him down, but it looked like there was a late hit after the play.
Major foul piling on. Runner number 99. 15 yards, first down.
Immediate first down when the Lions have been stopped defensively by the Argos. Ronald Clemens.
Well, Huntley right in the middle of the screen is the guy who trips him up. Clemens flops on top of the quarterback after he was already down. Number 99 comes from the right side of the screen.
Messam in the backfield again. Printers in the shotgun. Play action. Casey. Out pattern here. And O'Neal Wilson gathers it in right near the first down marker. Showing presence of mind to go out right at that marker.
Printers benefits from a nice job in protection from his left guard, John Hameister-Reese. Pulled out in front to pick up Ronald Clemens on the play.
So a few Toronto guys having some big plays here in the second quarter. O'Neal Wilson, Andre Dury, Jerome Messam. G-Roy Simon, that's back now. Kevin Iben made the initial hit. Then Willie Middlebrooks drove him back.
The Lions have shifted into no-huddle offense. Trying to change up the pace here. It's not necessarily a full hurry-up situation with a minute and a half left and only half the field to go.
G-Roy Simon continues to climb the all-time list. 18 away from Ray Allgaard. Printers out of the backfield. Finds Manny Arsenal. Just over a minute to go before halftime. Again, this will depend on the spot. Might be a little short. In fact, about a yard short.
Casey Printers even appeared to be motioning 2 yards to the sidelines.
Timeout, BC.
It's a critical situation with the Lions looking to score before the half. They want to make sure they've got it right.
Wally Buono shaking his head, looking downfield. Casey Printers trying to convince him. Wally says, let's go. Paul McCallum will retreat back to the sideline. Third and about a yard and a half.
Aggressive call here for Wally Buono. Field position factors into this decision. Watch play action here.
Offense has been so good in this second half. Messam is stopped. And as the Argos turn the ball over on downs early in the ball game, the BC Lions do here on their third down gamble that doesn't pay off.
Let's go, guys, let's go, let's go.
And this is where I think there's a perfect opportunity for that play action, as the entire defense is going to pinch to Jerome Messam to defend that run. Casey Printers has every opportunity. Look at Printers coming. He could keep that ball and come around the outside with a good play fake. Could have walked for a first down.
Eric Taylor with the stop. Argos have a chance to take the lead if they can get to the end zone. Minute to go before halftime. Lemon spinning, throwing. Ryan Christian can't come back to the football. He was wide open, all alone on an island out there, but Cleo Lemon was lucky to dodge a bullet in the backfield.
Well, we've seen Cleo Lemon throw a couple of great balls on scrambles or plays where he stepped up earlier in this football game. One to Andre Dury out of the gate, and also to James Robinson for his first touchdown of the ball game. This time he's got Ryan Christian open. Christian streaking down the field. But as he comes open, Cleo Lemon doesn't get a great release and the ball comes up short.
Second and 10 now. BC could get the ball back again. Pump fake, but to the far side, Andre Dury. Cut back again, and it will be third down, and indeed, the Argos are going to have to kick it back to the Lions. Still 55 seconds to go before the half.
Well, Cleo Lemon went to that pump and go again. This time, the Lions had the deep receiver covered up. Dumps to the flat to Andre Dury. Lions defenders are right there to stop him short.
Jamie Borum talking to the sideline, and Michael Shea, special teams coordinator. We'll let the play clock wind down.
Lions with no timeout to stop the clock. They used it moments ago in that third and one situation.
And wisely, Jamie Borum.
Timeout.
Takes a timeout and go back a few days when the Argos were in a situation like this, albeit closer to their goal line, late in a half, when their momentum was snuffed completely away when Jamie Borum had a kick blocked.
Well, and that was a case where the Argos had too much time on the clock. They were unable to run it out. They would have liked to have been able to get out of the half without having to punt the football. It was blocked and recovered in the end zone by Markeith Knowlton for a big touchdown.
And the head coach and the special teams coordinator, a little disagreement on the sideline about the way to play this out. Mike O'Shea, of course, one of the great linebackers in CFL history. Now a coach with the Argos. So Borum lets it fly with 36 seconds on the clock. Jonas Davis, another cutback. And another one. Down he goes with 25 seconds left before halftime. So a chance for a couple of plays to put it in field goal position with that strong leg of Paul McCallum.
It's going to be important for BC to not only get the ball downfield, but also keep those routes close to the sideline so they can get out of bounds and stop the clock. Again, no timeout left here for the Lions, so execution is going to be key.
Neil Wilson lines up near side of the field. Printers, quick back pedal. There's that out route on the sideline to the veteran G. Roy Simon. The most outstanding player in the league. Guy they call Superman. He has had a super career. Still ticking. His 35th birthday today.
Nice execution there on first down from the Lions, taking just 4 seconds off the clock. We'll look to get about three or four more plays in here before they have to kick.
Time for Printers. First down and trying to get out of bounds. Unable to do that was O'Neal Wilson. 15 seconds on the clock.
You could hear the entire Lions sideline imploring O'Neal Wilson as he caught that ball toward the interior of the field to try and get to the sidelines.
No huddle, quick to the line. Now one hopper to Stephen Black. So 9 seconds. Average play takes about 7 or 8 seconds. This likely will be the final play. Unless Printers can get a quick out pattern and then bring Paul McCallum out with a second or two left. Certainly a possibility here.
Yeah, given the yardage they're going to need to get into field goal range, as you said, this will likely be the one play.
Harris Jackson lines up on the far side of the field. Printers. Going to let it go to the far side. 4 seconds, and look at this. Jerome Messam out of bounds. 1 second left, and Paul McCallum does have a chance now for his first field goal attempt of the game. McCallum has been automatic this season. He's made 34 of his last 35 dating back to last year. He had a streak of 24 in a row interrupted. He's made 10 of his last 10. And this is well within his range. He is the CFL record holder for longest field goal at 62. His longest of the season is 50. And this is where it will be, on the 50-yard line. The final play of the first half.
A great execution by the O to set this one up. Good heads up from the rookie, Jerome Messam, to get out.
McCallum, kick is up. It is wide. Now look out. Chad Owens finds a seam, has more running room. Chad Owens to the 40, still on his feet. Owens to the 50, down the sideline. Hurdles, he's still in bounds. No, they're saying he stepped out. Took it all the way, and the official finally said he stepped out of bounds at the 35-yard line. Chad Owens almost took it back all the way. Got too close to the sideline on a rare miss by Paul McCallum. On an entertaining first half, an exciting way to finish it. Just by an inch.
Welcome back. Here are your halftime numbers brought to you by Tim Hortons, proud sponsor of the CFL, Jocko.
Yeah, you're talking about that voice, David.
We got one half left.
I was critical of the Toronto Argos last week for not using Corey Boyd enough. 7 carries in the first half last week against Hamilton. He's got 9 this time, 33 yards. I want to see them use him more in the second half. Let him have over 20 carries, and I believe that Cleo Lemon, with the way he's playing, they'll find a way to win this football game.
And I'm thinking G-Roy's happy with the 191 yards passing. He spoke with Farhan Lalji.
Less than 30 yards of offense in the first quarter, but things really changed in the second. What was the difference?
You know, we started out slow, but we got ourselves together and just started playing football. You know, we just settled down.
Casey seemed to settle down as well. Just talk about his demeanor in the huddle as he started to gain some confidence.
Oh, he's definitely confident. You know, he just had to relax a little bit. I think everybody's excited to be playing and playing at home. So, like I said, we just had